Hey, what's up, boxing fans? This is the Rope-A-Dope Report. I'm your host, Chris Carlson. I'm back with another video. And this one has to do with a fight from 1932. The country had just fallen into the Depression. And, no, I'm just kidding. I'm just playing. I'm totally kidding. What else are we going to talk about right this moment? Golovkin against Brook. And I'm going to say it right from the start. You know, I've heard a lot of people on social media, right? All the banter back and forth. I've heard a ton of YouTube videos out there, right? Or seen, heard, whatever. Podcasts, forums, the whole nine. Media members talking about it and writing about it. Here's what this fight is. It's a money fight. Plain and simple. That's it. That's where it stops. It's a money fight. Okay? That's it. Big shouts out to Eddie Hearn. You know, Eddie Hearn had two pay-per-views, September and October, in the balance. He could have lost both of those fights. He basically just kind of smushed it together and made a fight, okay? It's going to be on pay-per-view. It's going to do well over there. The tickets, it's going to be a sold-out show. And big shots to Eddie Hearn. That was a pretty slick move, you know what I mean, to recover from possibly losing both fights, potentially. And, you know, Eddie Hearn, I'd say, is the best promoter in boxing and has been for the last couple years. I thought by the time 2013 and early 2014 rolled around, I thought Golden Boy Promotions with Richard Schaefer at the helm had surpassed top rank in quality. But we know what happened there. So, big shouts out to Eddie Hearn. He got it done in K2 as well, of course, Tom Loeffler. But this fight, you know, I can understand Eddie Hearn saying, you got the best pound-for-pound fighter against the top welterweight and one of the best fighters in the world. I can see a promoter, because after all, he's promoting the fight. I could see a promoter saying that, right? Now, personally, I don't put Golovkin number one pound-for-pound, but it's definitely arguable. It's definitely arguable, no doubt about it. As the number one welterweight, you know, for me, Timothy Bradley, win, lose, or draw with his resume, I think he's number one. But we got a fresh crop of guys that are going to start, hopefully, and they've already started, facing each other. So it's very arguable, right? It's an argument that Kell Brook is number one. You know, if you think that based off Sean Porter and based off the eye test, that's cool. He could be. He could be. But he's not a top 10 pound-for-pound fighter. And before people start freaking out here, big shots to Kell Brooks. Kell Brook. Sometimes people over here say Kell Brooks. A lot of respect goes to him. There's a lot of people at middleweight that are ducking that fight, and he did. So I got a lot of respect for Kell Brook, even before this, but especially now. I really do. But I'm not ripping him by saying he's not a top 5 or top 10 pound-for-pound fighter. He's just not. So, and of course, with Golovkin, who's a major star in the sport, you're going to have a lot of haters, right, who are saying this is a cherry pick. Do I think this is a cherry pick? No, it's not a full-on cherry pick. I just think it's a money fight, like I said. He's not gonna get a lot of credit for this, obviously. He's not going to get any credit. He's going to make a lot of money, and it will boost his profile. As long as he brings a performance we've become accustomed to, it'll raise his profile over there. No doubt about it, like we said. But for Kell Brook, it could be a huge moment. It could be a historic moment. But this isn't a historic fight, and I think it's funny. You know, we hear Thunderdome Boxing, we hear Newton, we hear PP talking about Golovkin, and you know, they get mad at a lot of black channels for the Mayweather love and the Mayweather fan club as well. And we know once you're a star, you know, we saw that with Mayweather and Pacquiao. The fan clubs with those were just, that was brutal. That was brutal. Just to have a normal conversation with somebody. But The Golovkin fan club members, the boosters, they've come out in full defensive mode. It's one thing to correct an error. It's one thing to debate and go back and forth with opinion based on what you see as facts. Or, you know, like I said, correct an error. But it's another thing to defend and get defensive for a certain fighter. And that's what a lot of these fan club members are doing. You know, there's no, you don't have to boost up Kell Brook. You don't have to do that. And when I hear things about Sugar Ray Leonard and Hagler, there's a couple of similarities. Let's start with Triple G. Triple G and Hagler, they kind of have similar paths to the top, right? Both of them, it took them a while. They kind of had to grind it out. They had some promotional issues. They were having problems getting some big money, right? And getting some fame. And it took them a while. And Golovkin's kind of in that moment with Hagler where he's building his name and he's trying to get that big fight, but it's taken a while. They also have the blue-collar mentality kind of going for him. You know what I mean? And they both obviously have a ton of power. So if you have a blue-collar personality, per se, right? You have that appeal, that blue-collar appeal, and you have power, guess what? At some point, you're more than likely going to get a big fan base. So I can see comparing Hagler and Golovkin like that. Now, Brook and Sugar Ray Leonard, there's only one comparison you can make that really stands up. And that's a guy going from 47 to 160. Neither guy, Sugar Ray Leonard or Brook, have faced any kind of top-level middleweight, and they went right there, right? And that's where it stops. This whole using a ranking system to say Sugar Ray Leonard wasn't ranked at welterweight, well, no, dude, he was out for a couple years. He was out for a couple years. So why would he be ranked? And you're saying, basically, the consensus number one welterweight. Well, being the number one welterweight when none of it's gotten figured out just yet, or not a lot of it, I should say, that's fine and all. Like I said, arguably, I can agree. He looks the part as a possible number one welterweight. No doubt about it. I can see that. But to boost Brook up and say that there's some similarities there as far as he's ranked. He's ranked number one. And he's one of the best pound for... Come on, dude. Let's stop that. And when we talk about people saying a historical fight, like naming their video a historic... This is a historical fight? That's nonsense. That's completely nonsense. Now, it could be a historical moment for Kell Brook. Clearly, it could be a historical moment. Because if he were to go from 147 to 160 and face that big of a puncher, and a top flight fighter in the world and beat him, that would go down in history. And imagine what he would be a god in the UK history. It would be huge, but it's not an historical fight. To make it a historical fight, you have to have two people that already have history on their side, resume-wise, right? And, you know, PP said that, in one of his videos, he said, the main reason why Hagler and Leonard was historical was because of the upset. And obviously, going up in weight and also having 3+ years out of the ring, that's why he was an underdog. Now, he had a full year training camp, and he did take off the headgear and put on 8-ounce gloves and have a couple of fights in that time. So he was ready for the fight. But... I don't know, man. What made it a historical fight was not that it's close. That helped it after, right? It's not that there wasn't an upset. That helped it after, of course. But it's because it was a historical moment prior to the fight. Even in 82 and 83, you started, that ball was rolling. Hagler Leonard, right? Both fighters met in the ring, right? They both met in the ring with Hall of Fame credentials prior to stepping in the ring with one another. That's why that was a historical fight. This is not a historical fight. It's a money fight. Plain and simple. And I'll give you a line for you Golovkin fanboy club members. Just say it's a money fight. Mayweather took money fights all the time. Just say that. Anyway, it's plain and simple. You know, it's a money fight. No big deal. Peace.